footage from the Great Hall of the People. This is the second plenary meeting of DCS MPC session. On agenda this afternoon, the chairman of the MPC Standing Committee, Mr. Li Zhanshu, is going to deliver a work report, and it's about to start very soon.
Fellow deputies,
today is International Women's Day, and
Today's meeting, I would love to extend our warm welcome to Li Zhanshu, the Chairman of the MPC Standing Committee, Mr. Li Zhanshu is going to deliver a work report.
Fellow deputies,
on behalf of the Standing Committee of the 13th National People's Congress, I now present this report for your deliberation. The year 2020 was extraordinary in the history of the People's Republic of China. The Central Committee of the Communist Party of China, with Comrade Xi Jinping at its core, responded to risks and challenges the world has rarely seen in a long time, and we have delivered a result that is recognized by the people and by the world. New achievements have been made in the building of the country, and these achievements encourage all of us that we need to further engage in a socialist modernization drive of China.
面对错综复杂的国际形势，confronted
with a complicated international landscape and challenging tasks of pursuing reform and development and ensuring stability at home, the MPC Standing Committee, under the strong leadership of the CPC Central Committee with Comrade Xi Jinping at its core, continued to follow the guidance of Xi Jinping's thought on socialism with Chinese characteristics for a new era, thoroughly implemented Xi Jinping's thinking on the rule of law, and fulfilled its duties and responsibilities. The Standing Committee took active steps to provide legal support for advancing major work plans. Over the course of the 10 months since the third session of the 13th MPC, the Standing Committee has exercised its powers of enacting laws, conducting oversight, making decisions, and appointing and removing officials. In total, we have deliberated 35 reports, and 13 existing laws have been approved. We also deliberated 35 reports. And we also ratified or enter into 7 treaties with foreign countries. We reviewed and passed 39 bills, covering a total of 259 appointments of State Department employees. The most prominent feature of the Standing Committee is that we focus on major CPC Central Committee decisions and plans, and on people's expectations for the rule of law in their pursuit of a better life, and on the legal
requisite for modernizing China's system and capacity for governance,
in
an effort to strengthen legislation and legal oversight
to ensure that all
aspects of our work concentrate more on the central task of economic development and the overall interest of the people and the country. For example, we strengthened the legal framework for wildlife protection. We issued a prompt decision to completely ban the illegal trade and consumption of wild animals. And we also focused on poverty alleviation and focused on agriculture-related efforts. Using the weapon of law, we improved business environment. All this are providing legal support to high-quality development of the country. All these efforts are in line with the requirements of the CCTV Central Committee and the Central Government. And we are responding to the new expectations of the people, and we are also providing legal support and guarantee to the construction of the country in a new era. First, we strengthen the implementation of the Constitution and oversight of the Constitution, ensuring the full implementation of the Constitution is the most important task as we move forward. We improve the law relating to the Constitution, we also improve the NPC organic law, and over the past 30 years, since the law was enacted, it was amended for the first time, we also work to ensure constitutional order and the rule of law in the Hong Kong SAR. The disturbances that occurred in Hong Kong in 2019 over the proposed revisions to the extradition bill had a severe impact on the rule of law and public order. Last June, we conducted two meetings and reviewed the National Security Bill of Hong Kong SAR. In August and November last year, we passed the decision to add to this law. In this meeting, we are going to adopt a decision for improving the electoral system of Hong Kong SAR. The National People's Congress will stand firm in safeguarding China's sovereignty, security, and development interests in accordance with the law. And we will continue to perform our legally mandated duties and provide legal safeguards for ensuring constitutional order in Hong Kong, countering the false system in Hong Kong independence, ensuring that those who love our country can administer Hong Kong. We promoted the spirits of the Constitution. According to the decision and plan of the CPC Central Committee, we made a decision to award some of the heroes and followed by President Xi Jinping's signing of presidential order. We award Zhongnanshan the medal of the public and awarded Zhongbo, Zhangbo Li and Zhang Dingyu and Chen Wei the national honorary title of People's Hero. In 2020, we have received 1,310 pieces of legislation.
These
included administrative regulations, local statutes, and 378 normative documents in need of revision on Second, centering on the overall work of the party and the country, we strengthened legislation in two areas. In this era of socialism, the Chinese government, in response to the profound and complex changes in the international landscape and the rapid development of the cause of the party and the country, our legislative work moved into a new stage of accelerated development, marked by a large volume of expedited and higher standard legislation that covers a wide range of areas. We strengthened the enactment and provision of public health laws. We focus on developing a better coordinated and interconnected ecosystem and sped up the enactment and provision of laws to strengthen the rule of law with regard to public health, and we will have completed a further 11 objectives, including the Wildlife Protection Law, Practicing Physicians Law, and the Law on the Prevention and Control of Infectious Disease, and to improve legal awareness and greater compliance. We work to ensure that the release of information on COVID-19, allocation of emergency supplies, handling of social issues and disputes, maintenance of order in the market, and others are all carried out in accordance with the law. We also accelerated legislation on national security, including the biosecurity law, the export control law, maritime traffic safety law, and the draft of data security law, the draft of a personal information protection law, as the source of economic security, resource security, nuclear security, and so on. We carried out our legislative work to promote high-quality development and high-standard opening up. We formulated the law on urban maintenance and development tax and the deed transfer tax law, revised the patent law and copyright law, and incorporated the drafts of a rural revitalization promotion law, a stamp duty law, and a Hainan free trade port law. We made decisions on establishing an IPR court in the Hainan free trade port and a financial court in Beijing. We also speed up social development and social governance legislation. We passed Amendment 11 to the Criminal Law, revised the law on the protection of minors, the law on preventing juvenile delinquency, and the administrative penalty law, and deliberated the drafts of a food waste law, an anti-organized crime law, a legal aid law, and a family education law, along with the draft revisions to the education law. For example, Criminal Law Amendment 11 is a revision to the criminal law that has drawn the greatest public attention in recent years. We made additions or revisions to 47 articles and covers workplace safety, food and drugs, order in the financial sector, the business environment, public health, biosafety, biosecurity, and other areas. The draft food waste law also carries forward the traditional Chinese virtues and calls for socially conscious, healthy, rational, and eco-friendly modes of consumer spending. We continue to improve ecological and environmental protection law. We continue to champion integrated innovation in our ecological and environmental protection laws. And the MPC Standing Committee has formulated or revised 12 laws, such as the Yangtze River Protection Law, the Law on Prevention and Control of Soil Pollution, and the Law on the Prevention and Control of Environmental Pollution by Solid Waste. The Yangtze River Protection Law was passed in December 2020. It was the first specialized law covering the whole river basin. This law took about 1 year for the full deliberation, and the Standing Committee also convened a symposium on its implementation in a timely fashion. By resorting to the force of law, we promote that the Yangtze economic belt becomes a key model to benefit the people at large. We worked effectively to implement the civil code. Third, we conducted oversight of legal compliance and work performance in accordance with the law, thus providing support through oversight. We work to ensure that our legally prescribed duties were carried out within the statutory limits. We advanced implementation of the Constitution and law, and we strengthened the examination and oversight of the plans, budgets, and final accounts of the government.
Delivering blue sky, and using water and clean soil, and for 3 consecutive years, we have fulfilled the implementation of the law on protection of agriculture, soil, and the Charity Law and the Law on Provision of Public Cultural Services, and we have
at
the bottom of people's heart, the idea of observing to the laws and the soldiering, we are collecting the legal power in building a beautiful China.
坚持代表主体地位,
Fourth, we upheld the principal position of deputies and supported and assisted them in the law-based performance of their duties.
Since the third session
of the 13th National People's Congress, we have reviewed all the proposals submitted by deputies, and a total of 9,180 suggestions made by deputies were referred to 194 organizations for handling. The more than 400 suggestions which were raised by deputies were handed over to 98 organizations for examination and handling. We improved the mechanism by coordinating the handling of proposals and suggestions raised by our deputies. We also maintained close contact with deputies. We invited more than 500 deputies to engage in law enforcement supervision. We also foster close ties between deputies and the people according to the general arrangement of the standing committee. More than 1,800 deputies have participated in surveys and investigations, and we also strengthen the capacity of deputies in performing their duties, and the deputies are more aware in serving the people with their duties and responsibilities. We improved deputies' ability to perform their duties, and we also improved the handling of public complaints. In amending some of the laws, we are responding to the cause of the society.
NPC's function and role in foreign relations
and the service of NPC's overall diplomatic work.
And we focus on the main task of implementing consensus reached at the head of state level. We held 46 bilateral events at various levels. We immediately attended 26 video conference, made 15 phone calls, carried out 27 offline foreign affairs activities, and exchanged nearly 600 diplomatic letters. We stepped up friendly bilateral exchanges.
中法议会合作委员会第十一次会议，
主力国家关系深入发展，
推动多边交流合作，利用多边外事活动，坚定维护多边主义，坚定维护以联合国为核心的国际体系，维护以国际法为基础的国际秩序，
对
外宣介中国道路和中国制度。
We also try to emphasize the Chinese pathway and the Chinese system. We work to increase the international community's understanding of Chinese pathway and system, and we stood firm in protecting our national interests. We leverage the role of spokesperson mechanisms in the MPC Standing Committee, the MPC Foreign Affairs Committee, and so on. The MPC belongs to the people, under any circumstance and at any time, when needed by the party and the people, MPC will not hesitate to stand in the interest of our law, our diplomacy, so as to do our due duties to the people.
Six,
we work to strengthen the Standing Committee's capacity to perform its functions through constant self-improvement.
遵从法治，发扬民主，服务人民，
用
心高效，成为全面担负起宪法法律赋予各项职责的工作机关，同人民群众保持密切联系的代表机关的目标，全面加强常委会自身建设。
And we improve ourselves theoretically and politically. We raise awareness of the need to stay true to the party's founding mission and organize the thorough study of the third volume of Xi Jinping, the Governance of China. And we held the 26th local legislative workshop to study the legal ideologies and thoughts of Xi Jinping. We communicated and studied important speeches made by General Secretary Xi Jinping on many occasions, including the thinking on the rule of law. We also aim to refine the Standing Committee's operating mechanisms by giving play to the Special Committees. We convened 152 such sessions to efficiently complete legislation, supervision, and other tasks. We coordinate the promotion of NPC's work to tell a good Chinese story and a good story of NPC stories of the deputy members.
常委会工作取得的成绩根本在于以习近平同志为核心的党中央坚强领导，根本在于习近平新时代中国特色社会主义思想科学制约，使全国人大的
So that the deputies of the Standing Committee of NPC, the different special committees, and the organs of special committees could honor their commitments and take solid steps.It also lies in the State Council, the National Supervision Committee, the Supreme People's Court, Supreme People's Procuratorate, and different local People's Congress efforts. It is also thanks to the participation of people of all ethnicities. So hereby, on behalf of the Standing Committee of NPC, I want to pay my sincere thanks.
常委会工作还有一些差距和不足，主要是
立
法质量需要进一步提升，监督工作的时效性需要进一步提升，代表工作水平需要进一步提升。常委会将虚心听取代表和各方面意见建议，不断加强和改进。
Have to listen to views from all sides, so that we can comprehensively enhance
our work. Fellow
deputies, the Central Conference on Comprehensively Promoting the Rule of Law established the guiding position of Xi Jinping's thinking on the rule of law. General Secretary Xi Jinping has given important speeches for the work of People's Congress on many occasions. He has chartered the course and provided the principles for upholding.
丰富了人民代表大会制度的实践内涵。
The development of the cause of the party and the country has enriched the practice of People's Congress.
On a new journey, we have to
leverage the political foundations and advantages of the NPC and put people in first place. And, through the NPC system, we have to uphold the unity of the political leadership, the running of the country by the people and law-based governance.
各位代表,
Fellow deputies,
I now
wish to discuss our main tasks for the coming year. The year
2020
is the first year of the 14th Five-Year Plan,
and
we have to follow the strong leadership of the party central committee with Comrade Xi Jinping at its core, take Xi Jinping's thoughts on socialism and Chinese characteristics for a new era as our guide, and thoroughly study and implement Xi Jinping's thinking on the rule of law and his important ideas on upholding and improving the system of People's Congress, implement all guiding principles from the party's 19th National Congress and from the 19th Party Central Committee's second to fifth plenary sessions, uphold the unity of party leadership, ground our efforts in a new development stage, put into practice our new development philosophy, and plan the NPC's work around the 14th Five-Year Plan and the long-range objective through the year 2035, and exercise statutory powers to enact laws, conduct oversight, make decisions, and appoint and remove officials in accordance with the law, and ensure the NPC fully plays its role. First, we will work to ensure greater observance to the Constitution and enhanced reviews to safeguard the Constitution's authority. Second, we will strengthen legislative work in key areas and continue to improve the quality and efficiency of legislation. We will continue to apply systems thinking and give full play to the leading role of the NPC and allow the NPC to play a leading role in legislative work. And we will push ahead with legislative work in key areas and also improve the legislative system so that we can meet the demand of the people in building better lives. According to our legislative plan, we have plans to deliberate 45 legislative items with close to 20 additional items in reverse. We will continue with the working plan for enacting and revising laws to strengthen the legal safeguards for public health. And we will also formulate laws to respond to public health emergencies. And we will also improve our support to livelihood, to education, culture, social governance, ecological preservation, and environmental protection. And we will also closely follow digital economy, internet finance, artificial intelligence, big data, and cloud computing, and their application in various fields. Meantime, we are going to accelerate our pace in research into foreign-related laws. And this includes laws to deal with some foreign-related affairs so that we can form a system of legislation for foreign-related laws. Main areas will also improve our efficiencies of legislation. And in light of the actual needs and realities, we are going to expedite the legislation.
Third, we will strengthen the departments fulfill their duties in accordance with the law. The supervision and oversight work must center on the core tasks of the nation. We will try to implement the six stabilization tasks to maintain security in different targets. According to our oversight work plan, we have made preliminary arrangements for 29 oversight items. We have done the budgeting and the decision-making and auditing, the rectification of problems, and so on. And as to the TCN law, the pollution control law, the solid waste prevention law, and other laws, we must deliberate them. Fourth, we will take solid steps to strengthen the work related to deputies to give full play to their role. We will intensify the working committee, legislative and supervision committee participation in the work. We will also improve the suggestions quality by the deputies so as to truly keep a close contact with the people. As to the electoral system, we try to improve the selective system of the MPC deputies. Fifth, we will deepen and expand exchanges and cooperation at all levels and across all fields in order to strengthen NPC's work on foreign affairs. Sixth, we will intensify self-improvement efforts in order to lay a solid theoretical, political, and organizational foundation for the efficiency performance of our duties. Fellow deputies, on our new journey toward building a modern socialist country in all respects, we must rally even more closely around the CPC Central Committee with Comrade Xi Jinping at its core. We will strengthen the consciousness of the need to maintain political integrity, think in big picture terms, follow the leadership core, and keep alignment with the central party leadership. We will stay confident in the past, theory, system, and culture of socialism with Chinese characteristics. We will uphold Xi Jinping's core position on the party central committee and accomplish our responsibility to celebrate the 100th anniversary of the founding of CPC and work tirelessly to realize the Chinese dream of national rejuvenation.